Hello there, welcome to the weekly TED Talk with me, Gavin Webster, no relation. Well, it's been quite a week, hasn't it? And, well, it hasn't really been quite a week, has it? Loads of satirists say that it's been quite a week when nothing's happened on a particular week. You know, well, it's been quite a week, what with the disturbances in Chile and, of course, the pay dispute at Rantrees. And, of course, this was the week, of course, that where the famous BBC set designer that you've never heard of died. It was Bob Dylan's birthday. I'll get 80 years old, the Dill. He shot to fame in the 1960s as a folk singer, but although that was quite left field, of course he had a lot of mainstream hits, didn't he? And it created a genuine hoo-ha in 1966. Of course, in 1966 he went electric. In 1969 he went metric. And in 1974, he went scalextric, which, that caused a stir, I can tell you. Hence his 1975 album, Blood on the Tracks. I would be showing my age to say that I like Bob Dylan. Well, I wouldn't be showing my age. I'm too young for Bob Dylan, you know what I mean? By a long way. I don't know whether it's a cultural thing or not. I'll tell you a story. I was once at a service station with another comedian, and it was the middle of the night on the A1. We went to a place. We were about to get served, and there was a history book for children, and it was King Harold with an arrow in his eye, and my mate said, who was that against? I went, well, it was against William the Conqueror. And the woman behind the counter said, yes, 1066. Mind, I'm showing my age. I thought, why? Were you fucking there, love? You know, and when you talk about people in history, I mean, of course, Churchill, I don't mean nodding dog, our ass, or of course Danny Churchill, the right back for the football team that the Gordon Stewart, the safest hand in soccer, played for in the Roy of the Rovers strips. I know you're probably thinking of him. But no, I mean the former Prime Minister, Winston Churchill, who said of Russia that Russia was a riddle wrapped in a mystery inside an enigma. Covered in thick milk chocolate. Bite it and believe it, Clement Attlee. I'll give you a beverage report. No, he didn't say anything like that. But, you know, I don't believe that he should have had a statue. I mean, people want to pull his statue down. I don't think he should either pull his statue down or have a statue. Do you know what there should be a statue of? The man with the dog. The man with the dog should be, like the unknown soldier, the man with the dog, because the man with the dog has spotted more dead bodies in this country than anyone else in history. You know what I mean? I'd gladly have a man with a dog on Wall's End High Street, resplendent there with his lead. Not a woman with a dog, you know what I mean? Because they don't tend to do the early morning walks. Well, it's dangerous, there's a lot of nutters about. But it's the man with the dog who has actually saved money on police time by finding lone wolf dead in the woods. You know, it's... I'll tell you what, mate, it's not a snowflake with an agenda, it's not a woke with an Instagram or something like that, it's a man with a dog! Anyway, I've got to go. You've been wonderful. Watch what you're doing. Don't drink and drive!